Welcome to the Beam Corner channel. My name is Chris. Today I will present the third episode about tips and tricks for rhinosaurs while working with Grasshopper. Most Grasshopper users use Rhino only for visualization and import-export, while its potential is way, way bigger. In my opinion, neglecting learning Rhino is a colossal mistake. That's why you have to see this video. Enjoy! Drag objects. I have to admit that several times I moved Rhino geometry without noticing it. It's easy to do so by just selecting the object together with the mouse movement to rotate a view. This small thing can ruin your project, especially if it happened some time ago. It will be impossible to come back. Finally, I have found a solution for that. Go to Settings, Mouse, and check the empty box for drag selected objects only. Now, to move the object, you have to select it first and then move it. Little thing, but can save your life. Sketch in Grasshopper. Draw function in Grasshopper is not the best one I have ever seen. My created lines are always ugly and it's impossible to make a straight line. However, making sketches on your script can be a helpful visual solution thanks to the function called load from Rhino. Just right-click on the sketched line and choose Load from Rhino. If your Rhino geometry is placed near zero points, then imported geometry in Grasshopper will be placed in the top left corner on the canvas. You can import frames, lines, or even a huge text visible for everyone in a big script. More than that, you can import whole DVG drawings. In a colossal script, it will be easier to refer to a particular parts in your construction. For example, it can be the entire bridge or just a tiny cross-section where you can refer to your script with extra arrows. You can show which part of the structure refers to which part of the script, so that it's easier to your colleagues to work on your script.
To be updated and to learn all the secrets of Grasshopper, join our community. It's easy. Go to learngrasshopper.com, click the join button, write your email address and click the confirmation link in the email you will get from me. You will be getting all the latest videos, learning materials and interesting links about Grasshopper directly to your inbox.
Selection methods. This may be obvious for many of you, especially for those who know AutoCAD well. If you drag select with the mouse from right to left, you will create a crossing box with dashed lines. Now, anything you touch will be selected, even if the selection square does not enclose the entire object. If you drag from left to right to choose, creating the window box with solid lines. Then, you have to completely enclose the object you are trying to select with the rectangular. Good to know when you need to select one object among several lines around it. While freely drawing lines, holding some keyboard buttons can be helpful. First of all, holding Shift can block ortho directions. While making a line, choose the first point and after hold Shift to lock ortho direction and write the line segment's length. Second of all, if you press the Tab key before your second click, it constrains any direction. Unlike holding Shift, this combination blocks an axis between the first pick point and the mouse cursor position. You can specify whatever direction you need, and the line will change color to white while doing it. Once constrained, you can move anywhere along this axis to make your second pick point. These two combinations, Shift and Tab, work with any command requiring two points for direction input. In the previous episode of Rhino Tips and Tricks, I have shown you how to customize your pop-up shortcuts. Some of you doesn't like to use this toolbar. That's why I have a second option for the middle mouse button. go to Options and Mouse and click Run the macro and write grunt ZS. This macro stands for Zoom Selected Function. Now, quickly you can zoom to your geometry without typing a shortcut on your keyboard.
If you like this video and want to see more, go to website beamcorner.com/parametric-design to find more articles about parametric design and Grasshopper. Link can be found in description below. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Have a good one.